Hello world and welcome to another episode of FooBar. In today's video, we are going to talk about Amazon EventBridge Pipes. That is a new feature from EventBridge that allows you to connect different event consumers with different event producers. So this will be separated in two videos because if not, we'll be here forever. The first video, this one, we are going to talk about the feature, what it is, why it's super cool and useful. And in the second video, I will show you the demo. We are going to build the whole thing as infrastructure as code as always. So let's get started. So as I said in the intro, EventBridge Pipe is a really powerful new feature from EventBridge that allows you to connect event sources with event producers together and not only connect them, but also perform filtering and enrichment. And you will be thinking, but we have EventBridge buses already. Why it's so different? And stay watching because it is. So before this feature, if you wanted to connect like Dynamo streams with EventBridge or Kinesis with EventBridge or Kinesis to Kinesis or queues to, I don't know, Kinesis and things like that, you always need Lambda in between. You will grab the events coming on from Kinesis or from Dynamo Stream. You will run a Lambda function and then use the AWS SDK and put the event into EventBridge or into Kinesis or into a queue. So you always have this kind of glue code in the middle. And sometimes you could do filtering on the invocation level of the Lambda function. So you can do, okay, only trigger this Lambda function if the event has this payload, but you're quite limited. And when we talk about high throughput like Kinesis or Kafka or MQ, Lambda is Lambda. You have very different concurrency there. So you need to handle that. So if you want to process all the millions of messages per second you are getting from Kinesis and pass them to another Kinesis, that Lambda in the middle will be a bottleneck. So in order to address that, now we have pipes. Pipes are totally independent from EventBridge buses. With pipes, now you can basically grab events from Dynamo streams, Kinesis data streams, SQS, Kafka, manage Amazon MQ, and then send it to different EventBridge targets. So there's 15 targets like Lambda, step functions, Kinesis, EventBridge. Before passing events to the targets from the source, you can do some filtering. So if you want to filter out a lot of excess events that you're getting from Kinesis, from basically your click-through stream, you want to filter it out, you can. If you want to enrich that data, you also can, meaning adding more information or creating some kind of validation in there. So a couple of comments before jumping into some of the patterns when you can use this feature. The first one is the event ordering. EventBridge Pipes maintains the ordering from the events received to the sources. So if that's something important for you, yay, you have that built in. And then, as I said before, EventBridge Pipes is independent from EventBridge buses and also from the scheduler that we launched before as well in the fall. So you don't have the same quotas and you don't have the same limitations that you have with EventBridge buses. So that's a different limitations, different quotas, and you should check always what are those and if you can use them, but they're independent. So now let's look at some patterns I want to highlight when we are working with pipes and you can start understanding the power of this. The first pattern is loosely coupled components. We are in an event-driven architecture, distributed architecture, microservice architecture. Everybody's independent from each other. We want to have that and stays like that. We don't want to make architectural decisions based on others. We are independent. We are loosely coupled, but we need to talk to each other. So how we do that? We can use pipes. Basically, you can use pipes and connect these two loosely coupled components together. For example, one way to do it, it's if you have a component, you can basically add a queue in front of that component with pipe. So you can add an SQS and then attach a pipe and then send the messages to that other component. And in that way, you create a buffer and you can basically take the events in more kind of consistent way. If your two different microservices are already emitting events, now if one is emitting it to Kinesis and the other one is emitting it to EventBridge, now you can use pipe to connect them together. So this idea of loose couple components that they are very independent from each other now can be solved either by putting a queue in front where the other event is, other service is sending events into that queue, or then connecting these two event sources together. The cool thing with pipes and with this type of solution that this is low code. There you will see that there is a little bit of infrastructure built in, but you don't need to change neither the event producer or the event consumer in order for this to work. So your two systems are not changed, and we like that. The second pattern that I want to talk today is event enrichment, and this pattern is very powerful. So sometimes we have events that don't have all the information because maybe our clients don't have the whole information. So imagine that you are sending events from a mobile app and those events that you are sending, it just has the user ID in the events. And that's great because, well, we are sending events over the internet from the client to the backend, and we want to make our events small and compact, because small and compact when we talk about events and more in the mobile world saves battery and save bandwidth. But sometimes in our application, when we have these events flowing within our application, we want to have more verbosity in those events. We want fatter events that have more information, so then we don't need to go down to the downstream services and ask that information all the time. So one thing we can do is when those events enter our backend, we can enrich them with all the information. So we can do that call once and then get all the information we need and reach those events, and then we can start passing those events around in our backend application. So imagine now our client application sends click data with the user ID, and then the first thing that those events will do is go into the enrichment process. They will call Dynamo and we will fetch all the information we need from the user and pass it to the downstream services, for example, in EventBridge or in another Kinesis or whatever. And now our events are richer. And again, this is really simple with pipes. It's a low code solution. Our clients are not affected. Our backend is not affected. It's just this connection that gets richer. The third pattern I want to go over is the opposite. Content filter pattern. So imagine that you have a client or another application that is very verbose. So this client is sending a lot of personal data, and you don't want that. You don't want personal data for your analytics, for example. The more personal data you store, the more pain you will have to go through because there is a lot of regulations around personal data. So you want to remove those attributes, like those personal data attributes, before getting the events into your downstream services, for example, for an analytics processing. So what you will do, you will pass those events that are coming from your clients through a filtering mechanism that will filter out those attributes and will just continue with an anonymized version of those events that can be used for analytic and statistical analysis purposes. Other things we can filter out is also events. So imagine that you have, again, a mobile application. I like the example of mobile applications because this is very realistic and it's a challenge for a lot of customers. So you have a mobile application that emits a lot of events and you want to connect those events to your backend. A lot of those events that your mobile application emits are not really important for your backend application. So in an event-driven architecture, you might have some events like the user clicked this button and that's something you want to pass to your backend, but then there is other events that are for analytic purposes. So for your backend integration, is not that relevant. So you can filter those events on the fly using pipes as well. And again, for your analytics, you can drop all those other events that your backend needs to react on. So you start seeing the pattern here. And the last pattern I would like to cover is the message translation pattern. And here we have different components that want to talk to each other, but they have different event structure. And this is, again, very common in our loose couple components. Everybody has different structure. Everybody makes the events in their own way. And then you want them to talk to each other. And, well, the information is there, but the attribute name is different. Even the way that the events are written is wrong. For example, instead of putting the name in like first name and last name, one component will do the full name and put the whole thing. So you want to standardize everything and you want the different parts to be able to talk to each other. You can use pipes and solve this problem. So if you start seeing there is a lot of power with pipes and allows you to do a lot of things. So in the next video, I will show you how to build a solution. But now I want to go to the console and show you a little bit more how it looks to build a pipe from the console. But again, I will recommend you to do it as infrastructure as code, but the console will help you. So let's go there and build something. So we have here Amazon EventBridge. So you can see that if you go to the side, you can see pipes, you can see schedulers, you can see the buses. So pipes has the new one because it just launched. So let's go to pipes. And in here it explains you the source, you receive the information from there, then you can do the filtering, you can do the enrichment, and then you can send it to the target. So we can create a pipe. And this user experience is quite nice, but again, I recommend always to use infrastructure as code because then you can replicate the same thing over and over again and change things. But the user experience is quite nice. Let's see, test pipe. So here you can see that build pipe and you can basically configure the different bits and pieces. So let's go and select the source. I will pick Kinesis. I should have a stream configured. And here you can define where you want to start from, and you can also define the batch size. So this is important to handle the concurrency because, again, Kinesis, if you're going against EventBridge, the concurrency and the throughput limitations is different. So that's something you need to take in consideration, and you need to load test a lot these examples. So if you want to learn more about load testing, I have all my artillery videos, and I'm more than happy to do more content on load testing and how to load test event-driven architecture. So just let me know in the comments below. So here you can select the batch sizes. You can have one and you can define all the different things that you can do for Kinesis. Then you can define the target, and the target I can do pick from all this list. So I will select EventBridge bus, and I will pitch my custom bus. And here you can do some transformation already from the source to the target. So you can say, okay, this is my event from my source, and I just want to have the data, and you can, okay, this is the data. And you will do something like this. So you will do something like this. Here it's explained how it works. So you can see data. And here you can notice one interesting thing. If you work with Kinesis, for example, the payload, you will see that the data is base 64 encoded. But when you do the transformation, it will get decoded for you automatically by the pipe. And this is a very powerful transformation that it happens on the fly, so you don't need to do it. And I really like that because then you can access, for example, we will see it next week in the next video, how we can access the different bits and pieces from the step function to do the transformation and enrichment. And this is very powerful. And you can see here some examples on how this works and how it looks. So I really like that. So I have my target there, and then I can create my pipe. So I have my Amazon Kinesis Data Generator. This is a tool I use to send events to Kinesis. So we can configure it to the right place. Let's make sure that it's configured. If you want to know more about this, just I will leave you the link in the description box and you can check the information on how to configure it. But I have one data stream here, and I will basically just send a message. So I have here a random thing, and we can start seeing that events are coming in, a lot of them. And let's see if something is happening in my bus. So this is putting it here, and this has a rule. And this rule is basically writing to a CloudWatch log. So let's see what happened. So good, here is the latest. And we can see here that the whole thing has been appearing in my logs quite nicely and automated. Here we can add in this pipe, we can edit it and add filtering. So for example, I can add a filter here for only processing events that says filter. So that's something we can do. So we should be able to do something like this, and this should filter. And there is some examples as well here that you can insert. And now we should pass, for example, if we pass this one, that should appear in the log group because this has the word. So let's see. Stop. And here we can see it's coming. But then if I pass this one that says type no, it should not appeared. So let's send some records, let's refresh. Yeah. The last ones you can see are those iPhone ones. So that's kind of it. But that's the video for today. I just wanted to show you what is pipe, how powerful they are, what you can do with them, and how you can configure them from the console super easily. But stay tuned, because next week I will be launching the video on doing the infrastructure as code part, and I think that will show you the filtering, will show you the enrichment, and will show you all the different bits and pieces for you building this pipe. And if you want to know more about EventBridge features, you should check the playlist I'll leave you in the end screen. And with that, I see you in the next episode of FooBar. Ciao, ciao!